executives. He's getting some advice from his allies. They are saying, look, you need to calm down. You need to stay focused on tax reform. Most importantly, you need to not give anyone a reason to want to vote against you at this point. That is the advice he is getting. So why is the president still stewing? He feels like he's not getting credit for any of his accomplishments. Of course, you can check out his Twitter feed to see him tweeting about the stock market, tweeting about the economy, trying to gin up more support and, of course, more applause for what he thinks he has done right. Erin.
All right. Thank you very much, Sarah. And I want to go now to Rick Santorum, former Republican senator from Pennsylvania, our senior political commentator, and Gene Sperling, former director of the National Economic Council under Presidents Obama and Clinton, who spent a whole lot of time also trying to make those calls, wrangle folks to get these bills through. So let me start with you, Senator Santorum. Now we're here. We have this drama. Oftentimes you would see these things and say, okay, they'll figure it out. Yeah. But obviously the track record thus far this year is that there's been some pretty huge failures. So they're going to figure this out or not?
Oh, yeah. Obviously this is legit drama. There are serious issues here. But there is no doubt in my mind that there will be 50 votes, whether it's late tonight or whether it's tomorrow. There'll be 50 votes to pass a bill out of the United States Senate. And the one thing that I think you need to pay attention to is the two names of the people who are the most problematic right now, which is Bob Corker and Jeff Flake. Those are the two people the president has gone after and attacked. Now, you can say, well, that had nothing to do with the other. Maybe it didn't. But neither of them feel a particular affinity to the president that they have to do something to help him. Both of them are now leaving office, in part because of President Trump's opposition to them. So President Trump has to understand that there are consequences to some of the things he does, particularly within his own party, in alienating people come these very crucial votes. Neither of these folks should be where they are right now. I whether they lose both of them or not, I don't know. I think Ron Johnson will get back on board. I think they'll have the 50 votes to do it. I know they're working both of those issues. Yep. But this is a problem that is in part created by this administration.
And